Welcome back to the latest episode of the Laura and Becky Show. So most of you know the story by now, but we used to be on the radio together, believe it or not. We had our own radio show, but we got the sack. So we were worried. We were like, what on earth are we going to do? How are we going to pay our bills? So we took off to Mallorca with no money, had lots to drink and thought, you know what? We're going to try a podcast.
We are now sponsored by Prince Family Law Solicitors, Red Brick Estate Agents, and we're in collaboration with EMA.
We are indeed.
I bet it's busy there at the moment.
Oh, well, I bet we haven't heard from Johan, have
he's
we,
away,
for a few
babe.
Days. Oh, is he?
Yeah, he's off this week.
Is he?
How do you not know that?
Oh, how
do
I not
know that?
No, yeah. That's why we're feeling a bit funny today, because Johan's out of the country again. We always get like this when Johan's not around.
Yeah, he's away this week.
Oh, right, that explains a lot then. Yeah. Okay, we've had a little email come in actually as well. It says, hi ladies, I was listening today to your podcast about divorce. I got divorced nearly 3 years ago, and even back then it was quite a taboo subject. I ended up having, get this, a divorce party.
Tell us more.
Somebody has actually told me this before. They didn't really go into detail, but somebody has mentioned about having a divorce.
Well,
we met.
We were with. I was with you.
Oh, you.
We were discussing
yeah.
it. Yeah. She mentioned. Yeah.
I didn't have one. I didn't have a divorce party,
no.
But I'm intrigued.
Right. So we've just been on a walk, an early morning walk. And
yeah. By the way, what? I like an early morning walk. I
you're
enjoy
right.
it.
What are you looking for there?
Sorry, no, I just,
what are you ruffling through your diary?
I lost my place.
And so we walked around this lake and there were a swan and then three cygnets.
Yeah, you don't see that very often, do you? But they were quite big cygnets, weren't
yeah.
they?
So I went, oh, look. And they were just on like a grass verge, weren't they? And you went, oh, steer clear. Funny little phrase. Oh, mate, steer clear. Oh,
okay. I put my hands out to protect you. Now, I went, go back, steer clear, steer clear.
And I
turned into some sort of like, what are they called? Like, I don't know. What are they called? They like direct people.
When does anyone ever say, oh, steer clear? You usually write, oh, steer clear of that person. Do you know what I mean? Steer clear of him. Steer clear of her. But I just thought it's such a funny little phrase that I'm going to now start using it. Why aren't there signs up going, steer clear?
Steer clear.
Yeah.
But do you know what? You have got to steer clear of swans. They can be vicious. Okay. You've got to steer clear. We did steer clear.
Well, there's always like, we're kind of like a myth. We're like, they can break your arm. They can break your arm. How?
Mate, their necks are strong as hell.
What, they just how would they have managed to wrap?
If they whack it with their neck or their wing, they can break a leg or two.
They are. They're scared. They go...
Well, I think when there's cygnets and babies around, they're even more vicious. That's why I was a bit on high alert this morning. I was like, oh, steer clear. And I directed you to the other side of the path. I actually like moved you on. I'm like the police. You know when it's in like... In London, there's like another look. Steer clear, steer clear.
I think there should be like, you know, like the signs you have. You know, if there's like a skip on the road and they have like a sign saying go around.
Yeah.
They should say steer clear.
Do we know anyone who works for the council? Perhaps we should speak to them, drop them an email and be like, listen, you need some steer clear signs up around whatever lake it was we walked around. Because
anyway, if you see a swan, you steer clear.
Steer clear, guys.
Anything dangerous today, steer clear.
Oh, wrong
no
one.
Way doing that.
Also, whilst we were on our walk, and I think we can talk about this, can't we? You went to me, oh, I've come on today. And I went, I think I'm about to come on as well. You know when you get that feeling of just like rumblings?
Yeah.
Down there, I had that feeling. So anyway, when we came back from the walk, I had to rush to the shop for an emergency tampon run. But then... And perhaps we'll talk about this in another pod properly, but we had a discussion that made me think I shouldn't buy tampons.
Right, yeah. Well, yeah, we will talk about it more, but so basically we listened to a podcast, which was a Stephen Bartlett one. I actually haven't listened to that one, about toxic shock syndrome. Okay.
Yeah, it's an American woman. She was a model, I think, and she had a really heavy period and she wasn't very well with it, but didn't think too much of it, just thought it was a heavy period making her feel a little bit off. But her mum was really worried about it. Anyway, she collapsed in her home and she had, toxic shock syndrome. Anyway, ended up getting rushed to hospital. Really, really awful story. And... she had to have her leg amputated, but it was a really like quick decision, like to save her life, basically. So she is interviewed on the podcast. It's a fascinating story. I'd urge you to go and listen to it. Mm. But the only thing was with it. They were talking about what you're meant to use as a woman in order to not get toxic shock syndrome. And actually, they didn't really give an answer. So I was quite terrified. Listen, I thought, oh my God, I can't use tampons anymore.
Yeah.
But then at the end, there was no real like alternative or like solution.
It left you worried. It left you like, oh God, that could happen to me.
It left me terrified to buy tampons.
Yeah. Well, then I listened to another podcast and they were talking about that podcast and she said the same as you. She was like, it left me thinking, well, I need to know more. So she went away and researched a lot. So I listened to that podcast and she was talking about how careful you have to be. And I actually didn't really know what toxic shock, why is that so difficult to
say? Toxic shock syndrome.
Yeah, I thought it's if you forget you've got your tampon and you leave it in for hours.
I think that's what most people think.
But it's you can get it even having a tampon in for like 3 hours.
Well, this girl on the Stephen Bartlett podcast who got it, she was changing hers every 2 hours. Mm. So she hadn't left hers in any longer. And I think this is what scared me because that's what we all do.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, oh my God, like I'm going to get it.
Yeah. So I think obviously leave you worrying, but we're not going to go into it now.
Yeah. No. We've literally done exactly what Stephen Bartlett did. Don't use tampons, guys, but we're not going to tell you what to use.
Well, the thing is, the podcast I listened to was Nip Tuck Pod. Yes. Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Now, if you go and listen to their pod, it's two girls. It's hardcore, right? I mean, it is, even for me, sometimes I'm like, what are all the things one of them says in particular? It's quite, it's very, what would we call
risque.
It?
Risque.
Crude, would you say?
Maybe a bit crude.
But that particular episode, I was like, oh yeah, I was glued to it. I listened to them a lot.
I'm going to listen to it today because you need to know an alternative. So basically, when I went into the shop today, you and I were talking about it, and I picked up some some tampons. Then I went to put them back, and I picked up some pads. And then I thought,
just get both.
Stuff it. I'm going to get both. So there I was walking around with towels and tampons in the shop, and then I had to go and pay, and it was a young man. And I don't know why, it's still always quite embarrassing when it's a guy and you go and buy tampons, especially when you've got both, because he probably thinks, she needs pads and tampons. So I try and act really cool and unbothered, but inside I'm dying. And then he was like, that's it, pop them there, love. Yep. That's it, it's £5 for two. Okay. And he went, have a nice day. I was like, yep, I will.
I won't, because I'm on my period. Do you know what a cup is? A menstrual cup.
Yes. So my brother actually produces these at his company. I swear. At the business he works for, they make the cups. Well, apparently they're not very good either.
No.
I've heard that they're not even great. Because it's like...
I don't understand them.
No, I don't really.
Because it must be very tricky getting them out. And not spilling anything.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, yeah, I mean, in, probably a bit fiddly, but it's not full. But taking it out, it's a bit like, oh,
I didn't even know these things existed until my brother started going, oh yeah, we make these cups. And I was like, what's a cup?
I mean, they're plastic, aren't they, essentially?
Exactly. So that's why it's like a bit dodgy. Basically, there's what is that? It's tough being a girl. It's really tough. There's no easy answer.
It's not, no. And we're not going to give you an answer. Sorry.
No, but go and listen to Nip Tuck and they might help.
Although,
you
Although maybe don't listen to it that you've got kids in the car. No. Very rude.
It's very rude.
Right, what's going on in the world? So yesterday I had a little bit of a panic, funnily enough.
Do you know what?
A panic a day keeps something away.
I always notice with you, when you are about to go away somewhere,
terrible.
I can see the panic.
Do you know what I'm waiting for? My eye to go funny. I thought that yesterday.
Yes!
I thought it will go funny today.
It'll be tonight.
Guaranteed.
And also, what time are you up tomorrow? Because you're up early to get a flight.
So we're going to leave about 4:15.
So you're up at what, like 3:30?
4:10. Yeah. No, about 4:15 probably. Yeah.
You'll wake up and your eye will be funny.
I know. Something is going to happen that's going to happen today. So this air traffic control thing that we spoke about yesterday that happened on Monday, where it went down for 4 hours, I was like, oh, it's really bad. And then I didn't really think much of it until I listened to the news yesterday. And there was one person that was like, we're on holiday and they've told us we can't go back till next week. They have to stay an extra week.
But mate, that would be fine with me. I don't mind. If you're on holiday and you've got to stay longer, that's fine with me. It would be if I was this side and they said couldn't go, I'd lose my mind. But staying on holiday longer, I'd be all for that.
I think it depends. Because he was like, we need to go back to work. I think it depends on what you've got going on at home.
And, no, not for you. And it depends who you're on holiday with.
So basically, I then suddenly stopped and thought, oh my God, I've got a daughter out in Spain at the moment.
Yeah, what if she's stuck there?
What if I can't get out there and she can't get back? So then I actually said to James, I was like, right, worst case scenario, we could drive and get her.
Yeah, we are going to drive and across Spain.
Yeah, he was like, okay, now you're worrying now. But I was like, yeah, but we could though, couldn't we? We could actually do that. We just get the car and go and get her, right?
Yeah, or get the ferry. Mate, where there's a will, there's a way.
Yeah.
But you might get out there and then you might all be stuck there together.
Well, I mean, I think by the time we come home, hopefully, yeah. But we're still...
It's a bit up in the air.
It's not going to be plain sailing. A bit turbulent at the moment,
isn't it? Just
yeah.
You did actually message Paul Kay today, didn't you?
Yes. Let's see if he's.
We were going to see if he'd come on the pod because he's a regular listener.
I mean, he might be busy being like quite a top guy
with all of this going on. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think he'd.
He might be trying to solve it. Be like, oh, hang on, Laura and Becky want me on the pod. Everyone, just hold up. I want to know. I want to know what he thinks would have gone on in that tower.
Yeah. Has he replied?
Because you know when so when we were on the radio, you know when something like a tech problem would go wrong? Mm. Like I've got a brilliant video of you.
Oh my God, I know what you mean.
And the buttons are going wrong and your face, you go into complete panic mode.
Oh, I did not know what to do.
Put the mic down. And you're like, what? I literally launched myself.
I froze, didn't I? I froze. And my hands wouldn't move. My eyes were darting all over us. Laura was like whisper shouting at me across the desk.
The mic was up.
Yeah, because obviously she couldn't say too much because we were live. And I just literally, my body froze. And I didn't know what to do.
And that's on the radio. I mean, like the world's not going to end if we don't do a link properly.
Yeah.
But imagine, you know, when we were watching her land the plane, she has that pen, doesn't she, with that pad in front of her. Imagine the moment that all went dark.
Yes.
You're right?
Yeah, sorry. Someone's just sent me something on WhatsApp. It said airplane. How weird's that?
Oh.
Anyway, it's irrelevant, but how weird.
Yeah. And she'd have, did the screen go dark? I mean, I know they're highly trained people.
Yeah, do you remember as well when we were in the flight simulator and we were like landing planes, not for real guys, just playing at it. But even that was stressful.
I'm surprised we didn't get called up on Monday.
I mean, I know we need Laura and Becky. They'll sort this out. We did offer our services. We did say if ever you need extra bodies, we will be there. Yeah. But he did say, didn't he, like if there's really bad fog or really bad storms and things, they have to do it kind of like as if they're blindfolded. So listen, they know what they're doing. They're kind of trained for this kind of thing. And also, so are we. So, yeah, Paul, if you want us, we're ready.
I think Paul's busy because he hasn't. We'll try and get him on because I think air traffic control is very interesting.
Well, anything to do with aviation is pretty fascinating, isn't it?
It is indeed.
Just really quickly before we do our mate, we need to mention our Ringwood competition because it's the last day tomorrow. So you need to get involved. This is like an insane prize, isn't
it? Yes, it's so good. So basically, over the summer, we've had our summer wellness series. So it's 5 episodes. There's one about fitness, there's one about therapy, one about confidence, one about nutrition, and one about cold water therapy.
Yeah, and actually, we did it for the summer, but you can listen to this at any time because it's just how to feel really good in yourself and be your best self. And it's so good, isn't it?
Each episode is so good. All from very interesting women who've got very interesting stories. So that is available. Now, also to go along with this, now you have to subscribe to listen to that series. And it's like £3.50?
Yeah, it's nothing because it's £3.50. You can cancel at any time.
Yeah.
It's well worth it. It's cheaper than a coffee.
Now, also with that, because you've subscribed, we have a giveaway. So everybody that came on the pod gave us a prize.
Yes, they did. So we've got a Woman of Wellness supplement bundle, which is worth 120 quid. So this is all the supplements that as a woman,
magnesium,
you need to take. Yeah.
Vitamin D, really, and they're quite high-end vitamins.
Oh, it's really high-end. And literally, this is all you need. You don't need to worry about anything else. This is everything you need to take every day, which is incredible. You get a cold plunge session, which you're a massive fan of, aren't you? You've been cold plunging like nobody's business. Yeah. You get a discount code for a women's fitness app. You get a confidence coaching session and you get the Summer Delight Spa Day package for 2 at Ringwood Hall Hotel and Spa. So guys, you get all of that in one prize. Like, that is insane.
Yeah, we're going to put the details. We'll bang on about it over on our Insta. So go and have a look at The Laura and Becky Show. And yeah, if you subscribe, listen to those five episodes, enter the giveaway, and then you can unsubscribe if you want.
Yeah, guys, nice and neat. Go and do it now because it's the last day for it tomorrow. So yes, you need to do it today.
Yeah. Okay, mate, I am off to Marbs tomorrow.
No, what am I going to do? You're going for like 10 days, aren't you?
Yeah.
But 10... Right, you need to run this by me before you do it again. 10 days is too long.
I didn't realise it was 10 days.
Well, it's a week. Too bloody long.
I know. Right? I'm sorry. But do you know what? When I get back, it's going to be autumnal. We've got exciting things going on. We've got lots of meetings that week. I'm literally going to come back. We've got an event the next day.
Yeah, we're going to be into it, aren't we?
So...
Are you ready for your holiday?
No, I haven't even packed yet, but it's fine. It won't take me long. However, what I'm doing is the opposite of what you do. So I have, for the last 7 days, scrubbed my body with a body brush.
Fake tan's come off, has it?
Yeah, but it takes a while. It layers up that...
Do you know what? It is the bane of my life is scrubbing off fake tan. Literally, nothing seems to get it off properly. You can get a bit of it off, but you go red raw and it hurts, doesn't it?
Yeah, so I've got... When I got a present at Christmas, it's from the White Company. It's a dry body brush.
Any good?
Yeah. Use it wet. I don't like the idea of using it dry. It's a bit odd. But anyway.
You meant to use it dry.
I think it didn't matter, Rima. I just figured when your body's wet, it's looser, yeah?
Yeah. Do you use any product with it to get the tan off?
No, well, just gel.
Yeah.
Douche. Is that what it's called?
Douche, yeah. So anyway. You don't use a scrub? You don't use a scrub or anything?
Oh, Christ, not a scrub and a brush, mate.
Oh,
Jesus
really?
Christ.
See, that's what I use. That's why I'm red raw.
Hang on, a brush and a scrub at the same time?
Mate, I have to go in hard.
That's bad.
Yeah, and it still doesn't get it off.
No, that's bad. Anyway, so I was in the bath. I thought I'll have a little scrub, right? So I scrubbed and I had a candle on. It's very dark, but I was like scrubbing away and then got out the bath, like pulled the bath plug, walked to my dressing room, put my dressing gown on, came back. You should have seen the state of that bath.
Was it brown?
Oh my God. I literally just stood there and thought, it looked like, you know, you know, derelict buildings.
Yeah.
And you go in and like it's just like no one's been in there for years and you see the bathroom and the bath just, you know, look like that.
I bet it looked like a swamp.
Hair. Do you know what I mean?
And it all sticks to the outside of the bath. Does it? Even when you wash it away, you get like a brown line around your bath.
I just looked and I thought, that is disgusting. Yeah. But I've done it every day for 7 days. I don't want anything on me.
So you're going au naturel.
I tell you what though, when you look in the mirror and you've got no fake tan on your legs, I scared myself today. I kind of went,
I don't like myself. I don't like pale Becky. That's why I have to do it before. I cannot let anyone else see that. I don't even like looking at it.
If I wear fitness leggings and trainers and I don't wear thick socks, I have to put a little bit of fake tan on my ankles.
Yes. I don't like the white ankles.
That's really bad though.
Feel like I look ill. I feel like I look really ill when I've got no fake tan on.
So I'm going to, now obviously then you have the thing of the sun's bad for your body, like your skin. However, I am a big believer because I lived in Tenerife for 3.5 years. Did you know that? I was a holiday rep.
No,
did you know
that?
Did anyone know that?
You've never talked about that before.
I lived there for 3.5 years. I didn't eat healthily. I drank a lot, but I was never ill.
But you were a lot younger then, mate.
I know.
Let's just put that out there, okay? We've had a few years gone by since then.
I had so much energy. I do believe vitamin D is good for you. So yes. I'm not going to like burn myself.
Well,
but
no, you're
going to
wear SPF, aren't you?
A natural tan. Yeah, I am going to wear SPF.
Are you going to have it on your face?
No.
Good.
No.
That's good.
No. Oh, no. Yeah. No. My face will melt off.
Yeah, and you don't want to get wrinkles because that is what causes a lot of wrinkles.
Mate, as soon as I hit 40, my face dropped. It dropped. Yeah, I have to scaffold it back up. Yeah. It's terrifying. It's terrifying watching your face drop. It is terrifying.
Oh, I bet. Yeah, I don't want to think about it.
Yeah.
Well I'm 40 this year, so it's probably going to happen. 16th of November, vumph. That's it.
Honestly, you'll look in the mirror the morning you wake up, you'll be like, who the hell
Who is
I?
That?
Do you know what it is? It's the jowls.
Oh, no, don't.
Oh, it's horrible.
Well, you've got to like moisturise up like that. Moisturise
up.
On your neck.
Yeah.
Like, really firmly like that.
Yeah, you've got to get that gouache. Orange.
Yes, yeah.
Get them.
Always get a facelift.
Or a facelift.
Yeah,
even that thread thing, they thread your face, they go, and they literally just pull it back.
Ooh,
sign me up.
Nice, yeah, get us in for that. Yeah. So you're going to come up with a natural tan, right?
I think I am, yeah.
Lovely. Well, listen, have a lovely time. FaceTime me though, please.
I will, yeah.
Yeah, obviously we're still doing the pod whilst Laura's away, guys, so don't think we're not doing the pod, because we are.
We are indeed.